Dungeons of Drakkenheim's Kickstarter is coming to an end, and they are inches away from hitting that 1 million mark, if this video goes up on time. This awesome campaign setting takes place in the ruins of a grand city, thrown into a state of turmoil after somebody in space threw a bunch of rocks at it. With a lot of really interesting locations, factions, monsters, magic space rocks, and a buttload of stretch goals, it's absolutely worth checking out. There's only a couple days till the end of the campaign, which means that their current prices and bundles probably won't exist the same way next week. One of my personal favorite aspects of this campaign is these decks that they're developing. You can use these things to randomly draw anything from magic items and relics and spells, to alien mutations and sickness and weirdo spells. If you're interested and you have a bit of disposable cash, go check out the Dungeon Dude's first Kickstarter and give them some love. Thanks to a sponsor, now hear a video. Okay, let's counter some players. So in my last video in this series, I described how guards would react to players committing crimes. And I mentioned that in some instances, the party gets away, but their crimes are too much to let slide without punishment. So naturally, the city puts out a bounty. And depending on that price, often relating to the level of crime, you get a certain skill level. Because I want to be creative, and so you can strip some of these ideas, let's say that the party accidentally detonated a huge cache of explosives under a city, blowing up half of it. And the king, who manufactured them, is very happy to shift blame and spend a little bit of taxpayer money, resulting in the bounty hunter, Emperor. Before we visit Build a Badass, we need to take a look at who the hit actually is. I think the average party level is around 5, with a healthy party count being 4. So for a standard crew, let's go with Wide Waist Waldo the Wizard, Robin Richie Ragged the Rogue, love that name by the way, it happened organically, Beefy Bill Brutus the Barbarian, and Ranger Ricky the Fighter. Back to Emperor. To make a great hunter, strip all of the equipment, personality, and expectations from the character. Now pump them nice and full of conviction, observation, and patience. We'll make Emperor a halfling so he can benefit from a silver tongue and stealth. The highest passive perception a member could have is 16 without a feat or some crazy shit that someone's gonna make up in the comments. Which means that reasonably, two passive scores should cancel each other out, so with my decisive ruling, a +6 to stealth means that nobody can see him without actively searching, especially not a liar who pretends that their character's paranoid. So that will cancel out every player's first instinct. And now we actually get to play. The first 2 weeks on the job, Emperor will just follow the party. He'll observe their fights, what their abilities are, if they exhaust themselves too often, how they socialize, what they value, and if their habits are exploitable. Emperor is a funny little sociopath, but that's what makes him the best in the business. After those 2 weeks, let's look at our haul. Wide Waist Waldo eats often, has powerful magic, but needs to speak to cast just about anything important. He also can't run very fast and will likely get exhausted quickly if fought directly. The plan is to poison his meal with a plant that swells his tongue. Robin Richie values money over everything, but has an odd soft spot for Ranger Ricky. If their cooperation can be staggered, it might give us an advantage. Richie also seeks out hiding spots and cover, but only uses ranged weapons, so we should look for a way to take Richie's bolts or wait until he's low on ammo. Beefy Billy is a tough, one-dimensional cookie. If he gets close, Emperor will start to deplete his energy needlessly. But Beefy is dumb, and he beelines toward all of his enemies. He also seems to lose steam if he can't find enemies, and he seems to burn out entirely after 2 fights with other enemies. Last is Ranger Ricky, a prolific swordsman and party leader. His perfectly honed skills means that he is uncreative, and his tactics are predictable. In addition, he's honorable, which means he won't expect subversive tactics. He'll likely be the last one left and fought head on. Emperor now has a plan. Step 1. Find a monster den over a day's distance out of the town that they're staying in. Lay caltrops and pitfalls for the barbarian, then scope out and trap potential hiding spots for the rogue. Step 2. Post a fake monster listing with a hefty offer, directing the party to a new quote-unquote adventure. Step 3. Pay off Wide Waldo's favorite food vendor to sell him poisoned goods. Step 4. Pay some street thugs to trail and attack the barbarian tomorrow. And step 5. Wait until nightfall, during the least attentive watch cycle. Take any ranged ammunition as a priority with 2 optional side jobs based on the context. take any non-carried weapons while they're sleeping, and steal a valuable item from the rogue and hide it near the fighter if that's possible. Then cover your tracks, head to the site, and wait. Now, everything falls in line. The wizard eats poisoned food, with the effect kicking in 1d4 hours. The bandits later ambush the party, spending a rage and endangering the now disabled rogue. The party finally locates the monster, an hour after the wizard loses his ability to speak, leaving the barbarian and the fighter to take it on pretty much solo. They finally kill it, deciding to take a short rest and figure out why this situation is happening. And that is our chance. Round 1. Even though it isn't round 1 because he's been conducting this orchestra, Emperor strikes. He'll attack the rogue from a distance, knowing that they're more dangerous than the wizard right now. Miss or hit, they're going right back here as planned. With his first attack made, he'll duck into hiding, hoping to get an equally good shot next round while the melee fighters draw near. The next round starts, Emperor is still in hiding, and the rogue acts predictably. Not triggering the trap yet. It's set to go off if they move from the hiding spot. The fighter's up next, triggering a pitfall and alerting the barbarian to the presence of traps. The barbarian then marches forward, avoiding a pitfall but deliberately crossing a bed of well-laid caltrops. This slows him down. The wizard ducks back into the wide cave, hoping to wait out a short fight while his tongue heals. Scattered, partially disabled, and wounded, the party can now become aware of the Emperor's presence. Shifting his positioning around so that the barbarian has more caltrops and another pitfall to cross, he makes a... Wait, I don't even have a stat block for him. This could have been a stealthy commoner up until now. The assassin stat block is super unfair, so let's use a slightly modified gladiator. This is actually a super functional stat block for NPCs around this level range. So he chucks two spears that are reskinned as glass orbs containing acid, damaging the barbarian decently. The rogue then tries to reposition, triggering generic trap, which does half damage and fails to trap them. The fighter then climbs out of the pit with a dagger in his butt and a broken tailbone, launching an axe that manages to hit the bounty hunter. We cut briefly to the wizard, awkwardly wasting a health potion in an attempt to fix the poisoning while speed reading his spellbook for remove disease, which he wouldn't be able to cast anyway. The barbarian continues marching forward, so focused on the bounty hunter that he fails to avoid his own pitfall. Giving us round 4, the bounty hunter pulls out his machete and tries to take out the fighter in this opening that the barbarian has left us. We get a crit that pisses off the party and some viewers who empathize too much, but the fighter goes down. The rogue then has a moral choice, to try and save the party using a dagger or run for the hills. But the bounty hunter already knows them too well. Either they have no financial reason to stay, or their best friend just died. They're running. All that's left is a bloody barbarian out of rages and in a hole, and a wizard who just remembered they had a scroll of hypnotic pattern from session 1. The wizard grows some chest hairs, steps out, and casts the spell. As the barbarian begins climbing out of the pit, he witnesses the pattern, leaving both him and the hunter stunned. The wizard then runs off, ending the spell once out of range, leaving a duel between a dying barbarian and Emperor. Oh look, a cinematic ending. This could lead to a few different things. Half the party lost, and a Darth Vader-style enemy who tracks the living endlessly. You could do a halted execution that might blow up the other half of the city. Or a vengeful and reality-defying barbarian that hunts down cowards. That's my video, do what you want with it. These are like breaking down movie fight scenes, but in reverse. It's like narrative Legos. Alright, that was long, I'll leave you be.